ask, command, decree in his name. John 14, verses 13 and 14. And whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. As we continue to explore that whole passage of John 14 around that statement where Jesus said that those who believe in him, the works he did, we will also do, and even greater works than those we will do. Our goal is to try to understand what he told us, what he instructed us, as to how we will do the works he did. And what we are seeing is the first thing he tells us is about the use of his name. And when John 14, in John 14 verses 13 and 14, it says, whatever you ask in my name, that asking is not the typical kind of asking that you and I are familiar with, that is to make a request. That asking there really is talking about making a demand, or making a decree, commanding something to be done in his name. That's how we use that name. That's how we exercise the delegated authority given to us by the right to use his name. So we ask, we command, we decree things to be done in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So of course we can pray and say, Heavenly Father, I ask you in the name of Jesus that such and such a thing be done, a person be healed, a person be delivered, a miracle take place, a need be met, a situation be changed, a mountain be moved, a door be opened. So we can ask in the name of Jesus, ask the Father in the name of Jesus. That's one way of doing it. The other way of doing it is by commanding something to be done. I command the sickness to leave. I command the spirit to go. I command the yoke of bondage to be broken. I command this person to be free in the name of Jesus. So that's another way. By commanding or by decreeing, you say, let this be done in the name of Jesus. Let this thing take place in the name of Jesus. So we ask, we command, we decree in that name. And Jesus said, whatever you ask in my name, I will do it so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You see the whole dynamic here. The Father will be glorified through his Son when things take place in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ. So when we use that name, let us remember that Jesus said, the Father will be glorified in the Son as all these things take place in that name. We ask, we command, we decree in the name of Jesus Christ, because we've been delegated with the right to use that name, to exercise authority in that name. And as we do it, things will happen so that the Father himself be glorified in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ. This is amazing, this is powerful, but you and I must have the courage to rise up, ask, command, decree in the name of Jesus. His works will begin to take place in his name. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we ask that our hearts will be filled with boldness and courage to ask, to command, to decree things in the name of Jesus Christ, knowing that things will take place and that the Father will be glorified in the Son. Give us the courage to do it and let mighty things take place through each of our lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.